Repositioning.
I will take my pick.
Just so.
Still breathing, despite everything. One day I'll catch a break. Everything. open up.
I'll take that.
Such a strange disc. These Githyanki markings. Lae'zel might know.
A disc appears in your mind's eye. Lae'zel sees it too and considers the vision.
Tisu markings. Ancient. I recognize them, but I can't make sense. No. Wait. The texts are enciphered, but I've solved the pattern. It's a story. About Orpheus.
Your head buzzes in concert with Lae'zel's, but it hardly matters. Even without the connection, you'd recognize her discomfort.
A traitor. A dead one. This text is heresy. I can hardly bear to read it, let alone speak it. Very well. I will read it to you. The Prince of the Comet, Part 1. So it was that we were free from Geich shackles and turned our blades on each other. The heavens were shattered, and one great empire was divided in two. Gith traveled to the Hells to broker help for her people, her cause. Vlakith would have you believe Mother Gith proclaimed her our queen. Lies. Gith made no such proclamation. Vlakith seized the empire against the Mother's wishes. But Gith had nurtured a son, Orpheus, Prince of the Comet, the true heir. He knew Vlakith's treachery. Orpheus rallied Gith's honor guard and declared the throne for himself. The War of the Comet had begun. Disregard this drivel. Gith declared Vlakith queen of the Empire and her own son defied her. Orpheus would have ceded control to the Geich. She did nothing of the sort. Thank your good fortunes I'm a tolerant woman, or I'd have sliced off a few toes for suggesting it.
vast world out there.
Quickly, then.
I have a lot on my mind and, well, in it. Here we go. I spy with my little eye. Nothing of note, really. It looks so small from here. Strange place for a button, especially one that doesn't work.
New sounds to damp a dark oppression break. Is it the foul? A foul, contemptuous heel.
Long hours spent studying at your college come back to you. This is the opening stanza of an old play, The Roads to Darkness.
From out of love for me, not love for blood and steel. Command as you see fit, my lord, my liege.
Don't get me wrong. I love poetry as much as the next wizard, but using it to command an automaton seems a bit self-indulgent to me.
If you do not believe the secret show, reveal the truth.
Breathe deep and move.
Thank you.
ask.
Don't get me wrong. I love poetry as much as the next wizard, but using it to command an automaton seems a bit self-indulgent to me.
Unbeknownst command that I cannot fulfill. Of course, my love. Don't be afraid, sweet girl. What can I do? Sorry. Would you like a hug? Come here. For just a moment.
His arms are too tight and too low for a comfortable hug, as if he's meant to be embracing someone slightly shorter.
Remember, you are loved, Lenore, so much. You're doing great. And everyone will be so proud of you. As I already am.
My ring lit up. It must have been linked to that button.
Let me work my magic.
I've got a long road ahead. Time to press ahead. Maybe I need more pockets. hiding here?
Abandoned.
Got someone sneaking up on us.
Too loud, sun scum. Heard you stumbling. Can hear you blinking. Noise gets you eaten down here. Reckon I'll hush you before something hungry comes along.
His gnarled fist grips an axe.
Fine. I'll let you live. But spoil my hunt, and you're dead. Told you. Hunting. Slave ran away. Took Sergeant Thryn's boots.
Gotta kill the slave and fetch back the leather. Or the bosses in Moonrise will have Thryn's hide.
Sergeant told me to.
Besides, we're talking about a slave.
A bleeding heart, are you? Reckon I'll just roast and eat it.
Imperator,
be conquered.
Heading there.
Slow down.
I am pain. I am torment. I am death.
I will ascend.
Thank you.
ready.
With haste.
Thank you.
despite everything. One day I'll catch a break.
death. On the move.
Wait to sleep.
What creatures thrive in a lake this dismal?
Vessel wobbles on the lake's murky waters.
Let's see.
Room for more?
Mm-hmm. corpses. These creatures did battle with Duergar. Get confused by one, blown up by the other.
Were swallowed by a chorus of turbulent music, through one creature sing many voices, the harmony of an entire collective.
Sovereign, he has come. He is here.
The choir fades. A single melody rises above the others, brassy and commanding.
I am sovereign.
You see a vision, your lifeless body wrapped in fungal tendrils. The Sovereign is threatening you.
State your purpose.
Fungal roots weave through your mind, seeking your true intent. Then the Sovereign drones a new melody, cautious but welcoming.
I can mend neither skin nor spirit, but we still might commune. Descend to me. Let us speak in flesh.
The persistent music coaxes you forward. The Sovereign expects you. Her condition is familiar. Poison, derived from a wild weed common to the Underdark. She'll need an antidote soon, most likely held by the poisoner. Thank you.
whatever that is, I needed it. Why are you helping me? No arguments there. Felt like a hook horror was sorting through my guts. But... that cure did the trick. Quick sharp too.
I thank you for your help, but I gotta get moving.
Oh,
it hurts.
Girls' garters. Oh, I don't have time for this. My kin need me.
Maybe not, but you are. I need you to rescue my kin. We can pay. We're Ironhand Clan, best artificers in Baldur's Gate. We were on an expedition down here when the Duergar snatched us up. I got away, but not the others. The Greys have them digging out some old ruin across the lake. Some dusty temple. It doesn't matter. They'll work my clan to death before they ever get near it. Just mining for materials. Nothing unusual. But our work pays well. Help my clan, and we'll make it worth your while. I swear. Thank you. Only wish I could go with you. But here. I nabbed these boots from the Greys when I ran. I'll feel better knowing you're using them to kick some Duergar ass. I'll mark where I made my escape, and wait here, I suppose. Not much choice, eh?
Something's on my mind. What is the...
The Sovereign's thick fingers stroke the corpse at its feet. A droning melody greets you as the creature turns its gaze to you.
Flesh talker, I show you a memory. Watch and listen.
A violent vision grips you. Duergar, dark dwarves chopping myconid remains.
Our peace. They killed our young.
The Sovereign's song slows to the pace of a dirge. It is still in mourning.
We laid waste to many, but intruders remain. Lakewood.
The Sovereign's song halts as it measures your worth.
I sense your resolve. You will find Duergar invaders near Lake's Edge. Cleanse the rot. Destroy them.
I suppose such wicked killers deserve wicked ends.
The music shifts, still melancholic, but now streaked with hope.
Do you hear a new harmony? Serenity. I name you Peace Bringer.
Fragrant spores waft through the air. Your heart swells with bliss with your every breath.
Freely you have given to us. Freely you may take. The Guardian Gate is open. Go and claim your reward. But before this, I have another boon to ask of you. You have cut out the Duergar blight, but not its source.
In your mind's eye, Spore shows you a drow striding among Myconid dead.
Mia, this one is called. He hunted us. Hunt him in turn. Bring me his head, and I will know my circle is safe.
My, this sovereign likes to delegate.
The drow lurks in the ruins beyond the lake. Bring him death and return.
Seems the shrooms are letting in more people every day. You see a fella on his own on your way in. Dwarf. Balin's his name. Bald. Blue tunic. Dumb as a stick. Right. Never mind. Knock yourself out. But don't come begging for coin if you find him. You try to ransom him to me, you'll find yourself skint and stuck with a fat old lout. My useless husband. Sent him for an errand. It's no surprise he's made a mess of it. Lucian, where are you?
Want master back. He treats me good now. Doesn't kick me anymore.
Announces this book to be Flumph Mating Rituals. The scrutiny proves too much. The lurid text melts away before your eyes. An illusion. What remains are simple instructions written in a spare hand. The secret to forging adamantine.
Curious.